Pallavi Mataji. Today in this session, shall we revise one shloka? Okay. As you all know, before chanting shloka, everyone should sit straight, join your hands and close your eyes. Yes, we'll start. Shri Rama Rama Rameti Rame Rame Manorame Sahasranama Tattulyam Rama Nama Varanane. Now you should repeat after me. Shri Rama Rama Rameti
Shri Rama Rama Rameti
Rame Rame Manorame
Rame Rame Manorame
Sahasranama Tattulyam
Sahasranama Tattulyam
Rama Nama Varanane
Rama Nama Varanane.
Yes, super. Like this, you should practice this shloka every day and you should chant this shloka in front of God while doing puja. Okay?
Namaste children. Welcome to the GK session. In the last GK session, Deepa Mataji taught you about different modes of transport, isn't it? What were they? Road transport, water transport and air transport. Why do we use all this transportation? Yes, we use them to move from one place to another. You have your cycles at home, isn't it? And you may be having bikes and car. Why do you have them? You use them to move from one place to another, to go to market, to go to your relative's place, like this. And how do you think God moved from one place to another? Have you thought? Yes, God also has his own vehicles or vahanas to move from place to place. Shall we see some of the gods who have their vahanas? And what vahanas are there? Yes, this is Lord Vishnu. And where is Vishnu sitting? He is sitting on Garuda. Garuda is a big or a giant bird. We even believe that it is a mix of eagle and human. Vishnu uses Garuda to move from one place to another. He sits on Garuda and he goes around. Alright? Yes. And what is this? This is Nandi. Have you seen Nandi in the temple? Before entering the temple, at the front itself, you can see the Nandi, isn't it? Yes, Nandi is the Vahana of Lord Shiva. Few days back, we celebrated Shivratri. Then Lord Shiva mounted on Nandi and he came to earth. Yes. So what is the Vahana of Lord Shiva? It is Nandi. Yes. And do you remember the story, Fruit of Wisdom? Yes. In that, Father Shiva, he told his two sons to take or go around the earth three times. Who were they? Ganesha and Subramanya. On which Vahana did Subramanya mount to go around the earth? Do you remember? It was peacock. Yes, peacock is also a bird. It is our national bird. And Subramanya mounted on peacock to go around the earth. Why? Peacock is Vahana of Subramanya. And what was the Vahana of Lord Ganesha? Yes, think, even when you bring Ganesha to home during the festival, you can see a small mouse drawn or near the Ganesha. Have you ever observed? Yes. Why is that? Because mouse is the Vahana of Lord Ganesha. Okay. What is the Vahana of Lord Ganesha? Mouse. That's correct. And this is a black color bird. This is crow. Crow is the Vahana of Lord Shani. Okay, crow is the vahana of Lord Shani. What this is? Wild animal. This is a lion. You are right. Do you know lion is the vahana of which goddess? Goddess Durga. And when do we worship Lord goddess Durga? During Navratri. That's correct. So lion is the vahana of goddess Durga. Okay. Now all of you open your integrated book. There, open page number 46. Okay. There we shall read all the vahanas together once. Ready? Keep your finger and read it along with me. Garuda is the vahana of Lord Vishnu. Nandi is the vahana of Lord Shiva. And mouse is the vahana of Lord Ganesha. Crow is the vahana of Lord Shani. Peacock is the vahana of Lord Subramanya. Lion is the vahana of goddess Durga. Yes. All right, children. Now we all revise the vahanas of different god, isn't it? Now we shall revise the months of the year also. How many months are there in a year? There are 12 months in a year. What are they? We did a very nice dance in our previous session to remember the months of the year. Shall we do it once more? Will you do it along with me this time? Yes. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, and you turn around. Wasn't that fun? There is another fun activity to remember the months of the year. Are you all ready to play the game? Ask your amma to play along with you. It's lots of fun. Ask amma to hold her hand in front of her. And what you have to do is place one hand on the top and the other hand below her hand. So what happens? On one side, your hand is on the top and the other side, amma's hand is on the top. Shall we start?
January,
February,
March,
April,
May,
June,
July,
August,
September,
October,
November,
December. So there is one more way of doing this. What is that? When amma is going to hit your hand for December, don't allow her. Shall we try this? Oh, December. Amma is out. You win. Shall we try again? This time I'll go first. Okay. January,
February,
March,
April,
May,
June,
July,
August,
September,
October,
November. And now, when you're going to hit, you have to hit on Amma's hand, okay? Don't allow her to escape. Ah, December, I'm out. Wasn't this game fun? Like this, you can play this for the days of the week. Skip count of fives, skip count of tens, or anything that you like. You can play this with Amma, Appa, Ajja or Ajji, anyone at home. Let all of them have fun along with you.
Children, today let us revise the story, The Hunter and the Pigeon.
Once there lived a group of pigeons. They flew from place to place in search of food. A little pigeon found some grains spread on the ground and over the net. The pigeons came down to eat the grains. They suddenly saw the hunter coming close to them. On seeing the hunter, the pigeons wanted to fly away but realized that they were trapped in the hunter's net. The leader of the pigeons told the other pigeons that they should not lose courage and they could all fly together along with the net. After flying for a while, they reached the place where they met their friend the rat. The rat cut the net and freed the birds. The pigeons thanked the rat and flew away. The moral of the story is unity is strength.
Children, today we'll be doing an experiment with candle. Take a small plate, place a candle in the middle of the plate, add some amount of water. Light the candle with the help of Amma. Take a transparent glass and close the candle with the glass. After a few seconds, you can see the water is slowly getting into the glass. Now the candle stops burning. Children, by this experiment, you will come to know that without oxygen, candle won't burn.